compiled Nahj al-Balagha. And what was the origin of this great personality in the school of Ahlul Bayt? Now, you ask many Shia who wrote Nahj al-Balagha, they'll say to you, Imam Ali alayhi salam. Imam Ali did not write Nahj al-Balagha. Nahj al-Balagha was compiled by Sharif al-Radi. Sharif al-Radi and his brother Sharif al-Murtada are two of the beacons of the history of Ahlul Bayt alayhi salam. If you ask many Shia about the history of Shi'ism, many of us know the history of Shi'ism up till the ghaiba of our Imam. Do you agree? The moment the ghaiba happens, if you ask people about Mrs. Mufid and Saduq, and you ask them about Murtada and Radi and Hilli, and people like Ibn Junaid and others, such as Shaheed al-Awwal, Shaheed al-Thani, and the others of this ilk, many do not know. That's 1,000 years of our history that we do not know. Listen, the Imams of Ahlul Bayt lived for just over 300 years. Many of them we know about. But after the ghaiba of the Imams, there were certain ulama who preserved the school of Ahlul Bayt. Two of them were brothers. From one side, from the line of Imam Al-Kadhim. From the other, from the line of Imam Zain Al-Abidin, salawatullah wa salamu alayhima. Allahumma salam ala Muhammad. And these two, their mother wasn't just a mother, she was a scholar, not only a scholar, a lady who asked Sheikh al-Mufid to write a book on the fiqh for females. As many times we have the fiqh for males, but how about the fiqh for females? She said to Sheikh al-Mufid, write a book on the fiqh for females. He wrote a book called Ahkam al-Nisa. That book was written because the ladies of the community wanted to highlight that we want to gain as much ilm as you, the men. Many times, the men of the community can sit with the Mawlana, can chill with the Mawlana, can have a Q&A with the Mawlana. But poor ladies do not get access, although sometimes they can sit with the Mulyani, for example. You find that Sharif al-Radi and Murtada, their mother, because of her piety, one day an incident happens that leads to the glory of their births. Sheikh al-Mufid was on the Karkh area within Baghdad. You know the Karkh area. If you hear someone whose surname is Karkhi, Karkhi refers to this area within the outskirts of Baghdad. He was there and he had a dream. In his dream, he saw Fatima al-Zahra, salawatullah wa salamu alayha. Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa Muhammad. Coming to him with Imam al-Hasan and with Imam al-Husayn. And she said to him, please teach these two sons of mine. When he woke up from his dream, he couldn't stop crying. But how is it that I teach the Imams of Ahlul Bayt and I'm visited by who? By Fatima al-Zahra. That moment, a door knocks. A lady comes and she says, Salaamu alaykum wa alaykum salam. These are my two sons. One's called Radi, the other's called Murtada. Can you teach them about Ahlul Bayt alayhi salam? From that moment, he knew that these two boys were from the dua of Fatima alayhi salam. Yes? As in, these two weren't just ulama. We have 12 imams. But we also have a case where after our imams, there are ulama who truly were inspiring, as in Sharif al-Radi's brother, Sharif al-Murtada. One of his titles was Alam al-Huda, the flag of guidance. This man in theology, it's rare to find a human being who gave tashayyu as much in theology as Sharif al-Murtada. His brother Sharif al-Radi was writing a book called Khasa'is al-A'imma, the biographies and the particulars of the fada'il of the imams. He says that while I was writing this book, I was writing by Imam Ali, about Imam Ali, about Imam Ali. And you know, when you want to finish a book and you want to get past Imam Ali to get to Imam al-Hasan, you probably spend a lifetime just on Imam Ali alayhi salam. Yes? As in Ali ibn Abi Talib, however much you write about him, you can bring me all the pens in this world from now till the day of judgment. You'll not be able to elucidate the merits of Ali ibn Abi Talib. As in, if you look at our brothers in Ahlul Sunnah, one of their six main books is called what? Sunan al-Nasa'i. You have Bukhari, Muslim, ترمذي، نسائي، أبو داود، عن ابن ماجه. سنن النسائي. النسائي, why was he killed? Because he would praise Imam Ali so much. They said to him, praise Muawiyah. And Muawiyah does have hadiths of praise. That, you know, his stomach would reach a level where, because of eating too much, there's a world of gluttony and so on, which is mentioned in terms of the merits of Muawiyah. I won't go too deep into it. It's only been 3 years since I came here. When it came back towards the Imam, when it came to Imam Ali alayhi salam, the Imam, he would write the merits of Ali ibn Abi Talib. They said to him, you keep writing on Ali. He said, if I write from now till the day of judgment about Ali, it will not be enough. They tortured him to death. They tortured him to death because he wrote on the merits of Ali. And this is one of the six sahih. The sahih sitta, one of the authors, was tortured to death because of writing the merits. Therefore, Sharif al-Radi writing the merits, some group came to him. They said to him that we want you to collect the sermons and the letters and the greatest sayings of Imam Ali alayhi salam, because we want to continue to swim in the hikmah of Ali. Imam Amir al-Mu'mineen, as he himself says, I know the secrets of the heavens, not just the paths of the earth. If you want me to talk about the metaphysical world, I'll tell you how the universe was created. Even not just how it was created. Even I was there in the creation. I can even tell you about the cosmological world. I can tell you about ethics and psychology. Ask me before you lose me. No doubt. Therefore, he wrote and collected Nahj al-Balagha.